During an engagement between the State House Investors Protection Unit and officials from the Uganda National Oil Company, Proskovia Nabanja, the UNOC Chief Executive Officer, disclosed that they have already completed the land acquisition processes for the Kampala Storage Terminal. The project aims to reduce fuel shortages. Over 300 acres of land was acquired in Bulova, Wakiso District, to pave way for the project.
So our intention is to set up another terminal, a bigger one, in a place called Namwambula in Bulova. It will be a 320 million litre capacity terminal that we intend to develop in a phased manner, but the sole strategic intent of that terminal is to receive products that will be refined from Uganda's refinery through a product pipeline of about 210 kilometres from Hoima to Bulova.
On completion, the Kampala Storage Terminal facility is expected to be the second largest fuel storage facility in the East African region, next to Kipevu storage terminals in Kenya.
If developed in time and well, it should be able to serve the forward markets. We are in discussions with the strategic partner, and we should be able to see some work start after a couple of studies being done.
Uganda currently has only a single ginger-based 30 million liters oil reservoir. UNOC says only 6 million liters of fuel is contained in these reservoirs, raising fears of fuel shortage once the current supply is interrupted.
Because we have only 30 million in ginger, it's not enough. Naturally, most of the countries hold stocks anywhere between 30 to 60 days for purposes of security. Now, in ginger, if you have 30 million and the daily consumption of Uganda is about 7 million liters, that gives you how many days? 30 divided by 7, do the math. I think it gives you anywhere below 4 something days. So that's the capacity that ginger has.
Meanwhile, UNOC has assured Ugandans of a successful eco project, despite several concerns about environmental degradation.
But in terms of GDP impact for industrial park, it's about $4.9 billion. And then the balance of payments as well is about 849.
So our main function as the State House Investors Protection Unit is to ensure that we coordinate, collaborate, and promote the protection of every investment made in our country. And I can assure all of you that we are here determined and committed to continue defending, protecting, supporting, and ensuring that every investment in our country is well protected for the steady progress and development of our motherland, Uganda, the power of Africa.
Report by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.